Hi, this is David. I'm here today to talk about GitHub, and I want to just show you how to get started using GitHub. I'm actually logged in here with their, or not logged in at all, I mean, I'm in private window, and I've navigated to github.com in this browser, and you can see that I'm not logged into anything right here, so I'm given the option sign in or sign up. If I have an account, I click on sign in, it'll ask me for username and password, but if I click on sign up right here, then a wizard comes up, it'll ask me for my email address. I'll click continue. It'll ask me a few more questions. It's totally free to create a GitHub account. There are some paid accounts, but getting started is totally free. And everything I'm going to show you today is available with a free account. All right, I've already got an account here, so I'm not going to walk through this wizard here. I just want to show you how to get started with it. I'll close this. And this is me. I'm already logged in to github.com. And if I wanted to see more about my account, I could go to github.com/DavidGR. David Gerard is my username. That's one of the questions it's going to ask you here. But I can get to all sorts of things here down by clicking on up here. It has my face because I uploaded a picture of myself to it, but it might just have your initials on there. And from here, you can look at your profile, which is where I am. I can look at my repositories. I've been using this for a while, so I have a bunch of repositories, projects, organizations, all sorts of information is here. But I think the number one thing people want to do with GitHub is to create a new repository. There's a few ways to do that. One way is that I can click on repositories here or under your repositories here. Either way, let's just do that. Your repositories brings me up to here. It lists them all, and you can select this new button right here, new repository, which brings up this dialog. There are some templates that are available to you if you want to use those, but I'm just going to show you how to create one from scratch. What I'll do is I'll choose an owner. I happen to have a few accounts that I have access to. You'll probably only have one if you're just getting started. Then I'll give this repo a name. I'm going to call it GCast repo. How about that? The name just has to be unique among your owners, among your repositories. I don't have to put a description in here, but I will demo repo for GCast. It's fine if somebody wants to look at it. And then I can decide, do I want this to be available? Do I want it to be visible to the public? Or do I want to make it private so that only people that I invite can actually see and use this repo? I'm going to make it public. I'm generous guy. And that's all I really need is right here. I can add a few files to it. For example, if I check this, it'll create a readme.md file. Real simple one, not much text in it. It'll just have the title on there. I can also create a .gitignore file. A .gitignore file tells when you start checking code into your GitHub repo, it will ignore certain files. And there are files that you want to ignore. For example, if you're doing software development in pretty much any language, any compiled language, you don't want to be checking in your binary files. You don't want to check in files that control the layout and the configuration of your development environment. You don't want to be checking in files that maybe contain secret information like passwords and connection strings. So you want to add a .gitignore file contains a list of all those files. And if you're new to .ignore files or .gitignore files, or maybe you just want a head start on them, there's a bunch of templates for those. So I can come in here and I can say, you know what, I am doing a development in, let me just type in Java or Node. I'm doing Node development, let's say. And if I do that, then it's going to create a .gitignore file that is appropriate for a Node developer, which you can edit and modify if you want to. You can also choose a license. You don't have to, but it's kind of nice to let people know what they're allowed to do with the things in your repository. Are they allowed to use them in their own code? Can they use them as a starting point for their own code? When they start using it, can they make money off of it? All sorts of things like that. And there are a bunch of licenses that will define what you can and cannot do with this. I'm not going to go into the details of these licenses, but a lot of them are open source licenses that specify, you know, sometimes you can say, oh yeah, you can use this, but you just have to give me credit when you use it. All sorts of things like that. Select a license here and it'll create a file that describes what that license is. And then finally, by default, it'll create It just tells you one single branch. It's going to name it main. You can change that later on if you want to, but now I'm done. I'm going to click on create repository. And here's my repository right here. And you see that it has three files in it. It has this .gitignore file because I checked that box here and I said that it was for Node. And these are the kinds of things, you know, you don't want your log files to be checked into source control, your coverage files, just all these things here that you probably wouldn't want to check into source control. There's a license file here, and I picked MIT license. It just describes what the MIT license is. So if somebody comes to this repository, they want to know what they can do with it, then this will describe what that is. And then finally, there's this README file, and you can see the output of the README file by default is down here. The README file is written in Markdown. Markdown is a very simple language that allows you to format text. If I click on this and click on code, you can see there it is right here. Now with GitHub, I'm able to edit right here in the browser. There's a button over here, has a pencil on it, says edit, and I can, if I want to, change this. This is some text, etc. And I can commit those changes. Commit those changes is what Git and GitHub, the term we use to say we want to permanently save those changes, make them a part of our repository. And you see that it did change it right here. If I look at the code, it's still changed there. And if I go back here to the top of the code, it's listed right here and it's reflected in here. So, and finally, the last thing I want to show you is when you want to get tired of this, let's say you make a mistake and the whole repo was bad, you want to destroy it, or maybe it's just a demo. In this case, I don't want to keep this around forever. I only created it just to show you how to do it. There is a way of deleting this, and it's not simple, and it shouldn't be simple because you don't want to accidentally delete this. But the way that I delete a repository in GitHub is I click on the settings button right here. There's all sorts of settings stuff in here, but really what I want is way, way, way down at the bottom, the danger zone. And here we can change things like change it from public to private, disable some rules, transfer it to some other owner. Really, this is right here. This is the really destructive thing. I want to delete the repository. And it tells me, ask me, are you sure you want to delete that? I say, yes, I do. That's why I clicked it. And it warns me again, unexpected bad things will happen if you don't read this. This will permanently delete it. Everything associated with that. And I say, yes, that's exactly what I want to do. And then finally it says, I'm not really positive you really mean this. I want you to actually type out the name of the repo, the full name of this repository in here to prove that you're serious about it. And I click on delete this repository here, assuming that I've typed everything correctly. And it is gone. It's no longer listed among my repositories. Even if I search for it up here, GCast, it's not there. So in this video, I've shown you the basics of GitHub, how to create a repository, how to add some files to it, how to edit those files in the browser, and how to delete a GitHub repository. This is David. Thank you for watching.